Matt, welcome to the Channel One sofa.
Thank you.
Right, we'll get started, shall we? You're a dad?
Yes.
A blogger?
Yes.
And an author?
Yeah.
And am I right in saying that you've got an upcoming US TV show?
Theoretically. Based on Mambus, not Mambus, it's buried. What's the name of my book?
Tommy.
It's called Man vs. Baby in America, that's why.
Okay, got you, yeah.
Yeah, it's so based on Man vs. Baby, the blog and the first book, they're making like a script out of that with Sony and CBS.
How did you get from being a dad to potentially involved in a TV series?
Charlie was born in 2015. I hope to God that's right.
Yeah, that's what I read, so yeah.
So September 2015 he was born, and then about three sort of months after he was born, he went to sleep for like the first time since he'd been born. And we were just out at a shopping centre, and because he'd gone to sleep, I quickly sort of typed into Facebook how I was getting on, just to update family and friends and stuff. And then the following day, I had like 20 likes on it. I was thinking, bloody hell, nailed this parenting thing. Because no one listens to a word I say ordinarily. So 20 likes, quite a big thing. And then over the week, it was like 500, 1,000, like 10,000. It just went absolutely nuts. From that, I was like on telly and stuff. I was on this morning.
But have there been other people who just haven't seen the gag?
Yeah, it's 99% it's great. 1% pretty. I'm getting trolled quite a lot. And then after that, a couple of weeks, I just started getting calls from like editors and agents about whether I thought about writing a book. And so I said, yeah, I'd love to. And then signed all the contracts and then thought, oh shit, I've got to write the thing.
What made you go to Facebook to post it?
My thinking was that if I post it once to Facebook, that just tells everybody all at once how I'm getting on.
True, yeah.
Yeah, and then I don't have to sort of like, I don't have to text everybody. I don't have to risk them coming around my house.
So how did you feel when it all went viral?
Weird. It's difficult to sort of disassociate how weird it is being a new parent from what happened at the time in terms of it going viral and doing all the bits and pieces that came with it. But it's quite odd when that happens.
So what's been the best bit about this whole the whole journey you've had?
I like the writing. All my jobs have always been shit. I've had a succession of terrible jobs. Well, I once packed toilet rolls for a living for about 6 months. And then, this is the worst thing, but I was let go from that job and replaced by a machine that would pack the toilet rolls more efficient. And then I was offered the job back to clean the machine that took my job. Yeah, exactly. So I've had a succession of shit jobs. So and actually writing, I really, really enjoy it. And I did like an English degree sort of 20 years ago now. And I did nothing with it whatsoever. So the idea of writing a book, I thought, that's done, that's sort of gone. So the fact that little sort of daft little post sort of gives you that opportunity again is pretty wild, really.
Would you recommend blogging or writing, vlogging to sort of new parents to maybe like keep them sane?
Definitely. There's never a point in your life when you're going to want to rant more than when you're a new parent or whatever. And it's quite a good way of getting that stuff out.
How would you juggle it all, the writing, being a dad?
Winging it's the best. It's the best option,
isn't it?
Exactly right. Yeah. So you might as well just wake up every morning and just think, let's just try and get to 8 o'clock without anybody dying or getting hurt or getting arrested, and that's pretty much a good day.
So the best and worst thing about being a parent?
Keeping them alive is one thing when they're a baby, but when they're a toddler and they're just constantly marching towards the most dangerous thing they can find, whether it's like a forest fire or Mordor or whatever, they're always got an appointment with death, they're always walking towards that thing, and that's phenomenally stressful as well. And the flip side of that, the best thing is that I love him to bits, and it's and that is the best thing about it. He's a phenomenon.
But what's your funniest memory of being a parent?
One soft play I went to, it was a jungle themed thing. They had a snake slide that went all the way to the top. There was a big sign at the top, big laminate that just said no adults allowed.
Oh, no.
But I thought no laminate's going to tell me what to do. You know what I mean? So I put him on my lap. And we weed down the snake slide all the way to the bottom, came out in the ball pool at the bottom, looked around and thought, there's no way out. And all there was a little flap, like a little cat flap, like a toddler flap.
A little toddler.
That you can get through if you're 3 foot, not if you're my size. And the only thing I could do was phone the reception. So I got my phone, I Googled the number, phoned up, and there's like, there's a woman behind the counter. I was going, if you look left, there's a guy waving at you. That's me, I'm stuck in your vorpal. Julie came along and cut me out and released me from the soft player.
What's next for you then?
Second book's due today, as I say, Man vs. Toddler. I've got a couple of other things. I'm working on a script for a UK production company, so I'm doing something with that. Hopefully just keep writing, hopefully keep doing the same stuff, and hopefully just people keep buying it. It'd be nice.
I'll definitely be back.
Thank you
reading
very much.
The next book. As a fellow dad, I really enjoyed it. It was really relatable.
I appreciate it.
And it was great to relive my boy's journey through your humour. So it's a really honest portray of parenthood, yeah.
Cheers,
I really enjoyed it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.